add a cylinder by pressing Shift A and choosing Mesh Cylinder. In Edit mode, press Ctrl R and scroll the mouse wheel up to add some horizontal edge loops. Add a circle with Shift A Mesh Circle. You don't need too many vertices, 12 is more than enough. Move it away from the other object. It can be useful to turn on wireframe display to see the wireframe of the cylinder. Turn on snapping, snap to face, and project individual elements. In edit mode, select all vertices of the circle. Move or scale the circle as needed to line it up better to the cylinder geometry. Press G to snap the circle vertices to the cylinder. Now disable snapping. In object mode, join both objects with Ctrl J. Remove the faces of the cylinder underneath the circle. And then fill the faces where needed. In case triangles are generated, you can press Alt J to convert those to quads. If some triangles still remain, select the unwanted edges and press Ctrl X to dissolve them. Fill the gap by pressing Ctrl F and choosing Grid Fill. You can change the offset value to rotate the new faces. Finally, use Inset and Extrude to create the hole. Press Ctrl and a number from 1 to 5 to add that level of subdivisions. Then right-click and choose Shade Smooth. Instead of creating a circle, you can also turn a duplicate of selected faces into a circular shape. First, select 6 or more faces using Circle Select. Duplicate them by pressing Shift D. Move them away from the cylinder and scale them down slightly. Right-click, choose Loop Tools Circle. You can use Wireframe View in Viewport Overlays or Wireframe View in Edit mode to see the geometry of both objects. Turn on Snapping, Snap to Face, and Project Individual Elements. Press G to snap the selected geometry to the cylinder. Now the faces are snapped to the mesh. Press H to hide the selection temporarily. Select the 6 or more original faces on the cylinder again. Press X to delete them and Alt-H to unhide the hidden faces. Select the edges. Right-click and choose Bridge Edge Loops. Now you can select Inset and Extrude faces as needed to create a hole. Similarly to the previous method, you can snap previously made geometry to the surface to save time. You can keep these in your asset browser for easy access. First, move, rotate, and scale the geometry to roughly where you need it to be. Here, using wireframe display is again handy. Turn on snapping, snap to face, and project individual elements. In edit mode, move the geometry a bit so it snaps to the surface of the cylinder. Then close the gaps by moving the boundary vertices with vertex snapping. Note that to snap a vertex, you need to move the mouse cursor to the target vertex. Turn off snapping when that's all done and temporarily hide the selection by pressing H. Remove the faces that will be replaced. Unhide the hidden geometry by pressing Alt-H. Then join both objects with Ctrl-J in Object mode. Merge vertices by selecting all and pressing M. Then choose Merge by Distance. You may have to select all and press Shift-N to recalculate the normals. Now you can extrude the circular part. Another method of adding holes to a cylinder is by creating the holes first on a flat surface and then turning that into a cylinder. Make sure Loop Tools is enabled in Preferences. add a plane and set it to Shade Smooth. Subdivide the plane twice in Edit Mode. Select the four middle faces, right-click and use Loop Tools Circle. Inset the faces, then delete them. Duplicate and move selected faces if you want to create an uneven look. Add an array modifier. And increase the count. Duplicate it, set the offset to Y instead of X, and increase the count. Add an empty and set the X rotation to minus 90. Give the plane a simple deform modifier set to 360 degree bent with the empty as the origin. Add a weld modifier and a solidify modifier with some thickness. You may want to turn on auto smooth at this point. Finally, add a subdiff modifier. You can change the array counts to adjust the shape as needed. Please note that the modifier order is important. If you found this topic interesting and would like to know more, don't forget that you can find it in my Blender Secrets ebook, along with almost 2000 pages of other tips. To get an idea of what the ebook is like, you can download the free sample from my website.